Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in this series on Django fundamentals. So today I'm going to be teaching you how to log out a user. So once they've logged in, of course, we want them to log out. All right, so let's get straight to it. Okay, so if we go to our app here, which is to do, and we go to views.py, all right, we can see here, of course, this is our login view. And at the moment, once we log in a user, we are returning to like a blank page that returns a HTTP response saying you have logged in. Okay, now this isn't great. Okay, this was just a random sort of test here just to prove that the login functionality works. So what I want us to do now is actually to return and redirect to a HTML template, and I'm just going to call it dashboard. So the point is, I just want our user, when he logs in, to be redirected to a page that he has access to. Okay, now what I want us to do is to, first of all, create that template. So we're going to go to our templates, and I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to call this dashboard.html. So something very simple here. So this will be our dashboard. So users that have an account that log in will be redirected to a dashboard page. Okay. Now, from the previous lessons where we use template inheritance, what I'm going to do is just, let's see, where is our login page? Yep, I'm just going to copy this here. And I'm going to switch this up and say this is our dashboard page. Okay, so this is our dashboard page. Perfect. Okay, so that is all we need for now. And we will get to the links soon enough. So we have our dashboard page here. And what that means is we can now simply go ahead and start with our logout functionality. So we need to go to our to-do app. And what I want us to do is start with the URL. And here I'm just going to put some spaces, copy the comments here so we know what we're doing. So here I'm going to say, so we had login user, now we're going to say log out a user, very simple. And I'm just going to copy this URL pass here. So remember, it's good to reuse code so we don't reinvent the wheel. And what I'm going to say here as my route, I'm going to say user logout. And the view will be user underscore logout. Okay, so the same here. The only difference in the prefix is that I'm using an underscore here. And the name, very important, because we're going to reference our logout with the link. So we need to set this name parameter here. So let's say user logout. Okay. So our views hasn't been created yet. We're going to go ahead and do that right now. So let's do that. Let's create our view. All right. Copy the comment. So we want to just say here now, logout a user. Perfect. Okay. So what we can do, we can go ahead and create our view. So I'm going to say def. Logout. It was user, I believe. Let's see what I said. User logout. User logout. So we can just say user logout. Perfect. Pass in our request. And I'm just going to say pass for now. Okay, so we can see here, we called our view here user logout, which corresponds to here, which is perfect. We're passing our request. And now we're going to go ahead and actually write our view. So this is very simple. So all I'm going to say here is auth dot logout. And then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to pass in a request. Just like that. Okay, so the logging out user is very simple. Now what I want to do next is I want to redirect a user. So what I want to do is I want to say return redirect. And I'm going to put empty strings here. Okay, so I'm just going to leave this as empty strings. So what I want it to do is I want to be redirected back to the home page. Now, what I need to do here is, since we're going to be using it with our link, I need to add this name parameter here. So I can go ahead and just say name equals an empty string. Okay, so that will allow us to redirect to the home page once we log out. Okay, so that's what we need to do. And while we're also at it here, it's also good practice here to actually, let's not get so complicated. So here I have my URL pass here. So this is what leads to my homepage. The route, of course, as you can see, is an empty string. The name parameter is an empty string. And the homepage here is a view, which I have created. Let's go up here. It just here. So it just returns a simple index.html page. Okay. So we have that. Okay. So what we can do now is we can simply go to our login page here. So it's our login. There we go. And we want to redirect. So I'm going to say return redirect. And I want to go to, of course, the dashboard page. So before we can go further, we need to now connect our dashboard URL. So we go to URLs. And I'm just going to put this above the logout user. So what we're doing now is creating a URL pass for this template that we created. So we created a template here called dashboard URL. So this is where we want our user to go once he logs in. Okay, so I'm just going to replace it here and just say here dashboard. Dashboard page. Okay, so this is very simple. I'm going to copy this URL pass, just re-edit it a bit. Okay, and I'm just going to keep it simple. I'm going to say dashboard as the route, and the view is going to also just be called dashboard. So everything here will be called a dashboard. And the name, the parameter here will be dashboard as well. Perfect. All right, so now that our dashboard URL pass has been created, we can go ahead and create this view dashboard here. So I'm going to put it, I think I'll put it here. So I'll put it in order. So login, dashboard, logout. So I'm just going to say dashboard page. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and just copy the a very simple view here. So I'm going to say home. And I'm going to switch this out for our template name. So it's called dashboard. So I can say dashboard.html, simple. And the view, the function name here. So it needs to be dashboard. And in case you're wondering, just say again, the URL pass here, our views, we called it, calling it dashboard. So we need to reference it here as dashboard. Okay, great. So we have everything set and ready to go. So here's our dashboard URL pass. All right, our user logout. Okay, now we can actually go to dashboard.html. And what we want to do now is we want to go ahead and just create a link here. So when we're actually on our dashboard page, that we have a link to log out. Okay, so what I want us to do is we can just reuse here. So I'm going to reuse this. And I'm going to paste it here. So in case you're wondering, so it's just a normal HTML linking tab. So we have a tag here with href, with in Django tag in tags here, my URL. So it's a URL tag here showing in the login, but we're going to replace that with user logout. And here I'm going to change this link name to logout. Okay, so in between these tags, of course, this is what the link name will be. Okay, so this should all work, but before I do that, I want to explain everything properly so you understand what I'm doing. So let's have a look here. So what we're doing. So let's start from the beginning. So we have our login view, which we've done before. So basically, it's going to log in a user. And what's going to happen is once you've logged in and it's a success, we're going to say return redirect to dashboard, which means we are going to go to this page here, the dashboard page. Okay. And what we want to do is we want then to click on a link on our dashboard page, okay, with the URL of user logout to actually log out, okay? Now, let me explain this functionality. So the URL is user logout. And if we go to our views for logout a user, we are saying auth.logout request return redirect and empty strings. Now, you're probably wondering, this is a bit confusing. Okay, so basically, in a nutshell, what's happening here is very simple. We are going to click on this link called user logout. And we can see here the URL pass here, which has user logout, the view user logout, and the name user logout. So what is going to happen is we are going to be redirected to a URL called user logout. Okay, but at the same time, once we actually redirect to that route user logout, we are going to execute user logout here immediately after we go to that route. And then it's going to log us out. And the final sort of URL redirect will be empty strings here, which is our home page, because I set the name parameter here as empty strings and the route as empty strings. Okay, so basically that's what's going to happen. We won't see, once we log out, this user logout route in the URL when we say logout. Okay, we are at the end, going to see, of course, our home page, because this is, you could say, the final command. So I just want to clear that up, because some of you, I believe, do get confused with that logic. So at the end, we're going to see index.html once we've logged out. Okay, so I hope that made sense to you. Okay, so let's actually do this. So let's actually do this process. So here we're on our home page. And what I want to do is I want to go to the login page. And I want to log in with my user. Okay, and I'm going to say submit. So let's see what we're going to do. If this is a success, the login, we're going to see dashboard. So the dashboard HTML template, which is here, we're going to see this. So look at it. It says this is our dashboard page, logout. So let's actually submit and see. There we go. We see this. This is our dashboard page. And we have logout here. Now you can see the route there, the bottom left on the tooltip saying user logout. Okay. But like I said, what's going to happen when we run this, we're going to, of course, run this, of course, the URL pass here. We're going to route to user logout. Then, of course, just after, it's going to run views.userlogout. And we're going to, at the end, be right redirected to this blank here, which, like I said here, is our home page. Okay, so we will see the home page. So if we say logout, okay, we can now see we're at the home page, empty strings, and that's it. Okay, so this is how you'll be able to log out a user in Django. So I hope it helped and it made sense. So that's it.